Salutations, fellow countrymen of Zimbabwe. Greetings, revolutionary greetings to the barometers of class questioners, which are the students. Greetings to the overburdened taxpayers, our parents, all over the nation. I greet you in the name of active solidarity with the students of Zimbabwe, with the pro-poor, with the students who cannot afford to access education in Zimbabwe in our present time. I answer by the name Commander Bruce Moore. I answer by the name Commander who wants to defend academic freedom and rights in Zimbabwe. We are in a dire situation as the students of Zimbabwe. We are facing a terror of approach from the government of Zimbabwe under the leadership of Comrade Emmerson Damuzo Mnangagwa. Our current situation as tertiary institutions in Zimbabwe, to be specific, polytechnics and teachers' colleges, we are facing state capture of the Student Representative Council of Zimbabwe. We are witnessing this by illegal appointment of SRCs from Maswigo Polytechnic. We have heard the news that there was an SRC that was illegally appointed by the administration. From Bulawayo Poly, we witnessed that there was an election that was done without awareness of all the students in that institution. In Sekei Teachers College, we were just told overnight that there's an election tomorrow. In Kokwe Poly, we understand that the government, through the Minister of Tertiary Education and the principal who was politically appointed by the minister, declared that now this is the new president of the SRC, which was not voted for by the students. So we are facing a state capture in the Student Representative Council. The duties of the Student Representative Council is to defend and promote academic freedom and rights of the students in general. The purpose of the Student Representative Council is to represent the students, regardless of color, creed, race, or political party. The purpose of the Student Representative Council is to make sure that they become the voice of the voiceless. But what happens with the political appointment? What happens with the illegal appointment of the SRCs? It is the hijacking protocol. It is the hijacking agenda of the students' voice and the oppression method that is being used by the government of Zimbabwe to make sure that they are in control and they are in charge in students' affairs. We are witnessing this in our polytechnics and in our teachers' colleges in Zimbabwe. And we wonder why the question of Zimbabwe emphasizes on Zimbabwe being the democratic nation. We wonder why our so-called leaders, whom of course we didn't vote for, claim that they are leaders of the people, whereas they don't follow what is in the constitution, which is the supreme law of our land. We believe that we are a democratic country. But we have witnessed that the democratic term is just being used as a term in a paper, but it's not expressed and it's not practiced by those who are in power. We urge the government of Zimbabwe to stop capturing our SRCs from teachers' colleges. We know the agenda behind. The agenda behind, number one, is to make sure that the students' voices are suppressed. Number two is to make sure that student representation is nullified at its own cost. Number three is to make sure that they push their own agenda and their own interest, suppressing the students' voices through SRCs, because we understand that SRCs have the power and SRCs have the commanding voice over the students. Issue number two that we are facing as polytechnics and teachers' colleges in Zimbabwe, it is the seclusion, or should I say exclusion, of SRCs or students per se in decision making. Earlier, January 4, 2021, we had a conflict with the Minister of Higher and Tertiary Education after they announced the increment of fees 4 days before the opening of institutions. We asked them, number one, the protocol or the procedure of increasing fees is through only by consulting the students on ground and understanding what are the pressure points that are at institutions. Then coming up with a resolution to increase fees, basing on the materialistic things that you want to address as a minister, to develop, of course, quality education according to Section 75 of the Constitution of Zimbabwe. But what we experienced and witnessed is the ministry, through their, of course, politically appointed principals from the institutions came up with a resolution to increase fees without our awareness as the students. And we believe that a project for the students without the students is not for the students. So the exclusion of SRCs and students in decision making at polytechnics and teachers college, and teachers colleges is worrisome to our generation. It's worrisome to our democratic space as the citizen of Zimbabwe. It's worrisome to our future, because Joshua Nkomo Nkomo once said, "The country will not die, but the young will save it." He believed in the young. He believed in us as the students, as the majority, to save the nation. How? Through innovative ideas to develop economy. Through an energy to defend our political structure as a nation, through an idea to make sure and assure that we put our efforts and our mind and appetite to save and defend our nation's founding principles and values. Number three, what we are facing at polytechnics is the issue of fees. 82% of the students from polytechnics and teachers' colleges, they have not afforded to pay fees. That was announced, of course, on the 3rd of January 2021. We clearly stated and we petitioned the minister and the parliament in itself. According to Section 299, the parliament has a mandate to make sure that they oversee the operations of any government agents. So we petitioned them, expressing our views as the majority, as the employee of the minister, and of course, as the major stakeholders of the ministry. The students said, "We cannot afford these fees because of A, B, C, D, E, F, G." Then they gave their recommendations. 82% they couldn't afford to pay that fees. And up to date, we're experiencing situations. Number one, at Mashingo Poly, students were denied to access institutional facilities. They couldn't afford to write their final exams because they didn't pay their full fees. Number two, at Bevetia Teachers College, on the 10th of October, they're writing exams. And the institution is very clear that no one will access the institutional facilities without paying full fees. At Repol, which we witnessed the brutality, the wickedness of the state, whereby the principal, one comrade, Engineer Mdondo, called the riot to beat students who were just expressing their position, where they were saying, "We cannot pay fees because we cannot afford. Equally, we want to access education because it is our right according to the supreme law of our land, Section 75. We heard this also at Mtare Poly, whereby students were denied access to the institution. Almost all the polytechnics in Bevetia Teachers Colleges, comrades were arrested. Female cadres, 80% of female cadres, just speaking their voice that they cannot afford fees. They were arrested and beaten above all because they couldn't afford to pay fees. We claim that we have a government for the people. We claim that we have a government that was voted by the people. We claim that we have a government that understands the will of the people. But what we are experiencing as the students, as the citizens, as the youth, as the majority, is that we don't have a father. We are like orphans. Because we can't claim that we have a father who doesn't listen to the concerns. We can't say we have a father who doesn't listen to the problems. We can't say we have a father who doesn't listen to the primary situations that students are facing at tertiary institutions. Number three. We are having a challenge whereby the principals, the political appointment of the principals by the ruling party, it is directly having an impact in our students' affairs at colleges. The decisions that is being made by the principals, we are aware that these are not their personal decisions. This is not a mandate from the ministry, but it's a mandate from the ruling party, because the principals are politically appointed by the minister through the recommendation of the president. Then we want to urge the ministry and the government of Zimbabwe, since it is following a democratic process of the Constitution of Zimbabwe, to ensure that they grasp and adopt a situation whereby the principals or the vice chancellors of the universities, they are not appointed by one man who wants to protect his interest, but they are publicly interviewed, the students being involved as the major stakeholders, to interview and understand the position of the one that wants to contest as the principal. And the principal assume the position of being a principal after a public confidence from the students, number one, from the parents, number two, because these are the parents who pay fees, these are parents who pay tax in Zimbabwe, of course, and from the ministry, number three. So we are in disagreement with the political opinion of the principals, because we have seen and understood that this is the root problem and this is the root cause of our challenges at polytechnics in Zimbabwe, whereby the ideas, whereby the implementations and the policies are not coming in the scenario whereby the principal is understanding what is on ground, but is coming from the interest of the ruling party projecting their political agendas, which are affecting the students. And we say no to that cause. We urge the government of Zimbabwe to listen to the public, to listen to the pro-poor, to listen to the masses of Zimbabwe, to listen to the students on that cause. The last problem that we are having is polytechnics. It is an issue whereby we are limited. We are not allowed to have that freedom of association. A normal democratic country allows freedom of association, because one must feel entitled to associate with any organization, with any political party, with any union of his or her choice. But what we are experiencing as polytechnics, what we are experiencing as teachers' colleges is, number one, if you are a member of ZINASU, you are not allowed to exist in that college. If you are a member of ZINASU, you are not allowed to contest even for SRC. If you are a member of ZINASU, you are not allowed even to proffer solutions and ideas that can better our education system. They are actually formalizing and normalizing and actually appointing and elevating ZIKOSU, because ZIKOSU is an affiliate of the ruling party, which is ZANU-PF. So equally, and in our understanding as intellectuals, in our understanding as revolutionists, is because ZANU-PF is in power and ZANU-PF wants to protect its rulership upon the poor, upon the masses of Zimbabwe, they can also use their power upon elevating ZIKOSU to be functional more than ZINASU in our institutions. Why am I saying so? Is number one, Harare Poly principal right now, he refuses, he's still in trouble, he's still in that sense of not wanting to accommodate, to elevate, and to appreciate, and to let the students who are affiliated with the ZINASU, to associate with it freely and fairly without any sense of fear or doubt. Number two, it's not only in Harare Poly, but even in Bevedia Teachers College, we have experienced the arrest of the students, the academic freedom fighters. We have experienced the beatings and the torture and the abductions of the students and leaders, because they are saying they are affiliated with the ZINASU. And we are saying we are a democratic country. We are saying we are led by democracy. We are led by the people. Why then do we say we have to divide in classes, a lacuna of those who are of the elite and those who are of the poor? Whereas we are saying we want to improve a scenario whereby students are represented equally. So that's what we are facing at tertiary institutions. And we urge the ministry to understand the mandate of the Constitution of Zimbabwe. Should I call it the people-driven Constitution of Zimbabwe? We urge the ministry to make sure that educational institutions, they create a platform whereby a student has the right to affiliate with any union that he or she feels like is fit and deemed necessary for him or her to associate with. We as the students of Zimbabwe, united in our diversity against all forms of suppression, oppression, corruption, and all forms that are confronting us, all forms that are confronting our revolutionary mandate, all forms that are confronting our academic freedom, all forms that are confronting our students' rights, all forms that are confronting the existence of those who want to stand for every injustice, all forms that are confronting the democratic space in Zimbabwe, all forms that are confronting the will of the people, we say no to state capture of SRCs. We say no to privatization of our education. We say no to political appointment of the principals in institutions. We say no to brutality, torture, and abductions of student leaders. We are a people. We might be coming from different political parties, different race, different families, different backgrounds, but we are a people. We are created by one God. We breathe air from the same atmosphere. We drink water from the same source. We are a people. We are Zimbabweans. We are blacks. We believe in unity. We believe in peace. We believe in equality. We believe in democracy. We believe in citizens' participation in decisions that concerns them the most. I salute you all academic freedom fighters all over the nation, from Zambezi to Limpopo. I salute you all students leaders who want to defend the students' rights. I salute all students of Zimbabwe who wants to ensure and make sure that we protect our education sector in Zimbabwe. From what Nelson Mandela goes on to say, educate Africa and it shall be great. I salute all academic freedom fighters who lost their lives trying to defend the cause, the initiative of the students in Zimbabwe. I salute all those who are standing against injustices. I salute all. I say long live to the comrades who are clear in our revolutionary stance. Long live to the comrades who are clear in defending our educational sector in Zimbabwe. Long live to the comrades who are confronting every injustice that is implemented by ZANU-PF. Long live to the comrades who are not separating people because of race, because of gender, because of political affiliation, but who are uniting people because of unity of purpose, because of the betterment of the country, because of being patriotical in the country. Long live comrades. Thank you so much for this time. Thank you so much for this opportunity. Going forward, comrades, what needs to be done in politics and teachers' colleges? We declare a 7 days of action on ground. We declare a 7 days of reclaiming our space as students. We declare 7 days of make sure that we protect the academic freedom. We declare 7 days of reclaiming our students' rights according to Section 75. We declare 7 days of engaging. We declare 7 days of fighting for a democratic space in Zimbabwe. We declare 7 days of a free Zimbabwe, where students are allowed to participate in national discourse. We declare 7 days of quality education. We declare 7 days of heroism. We declare 7 days of Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe must be saved. Our luta continue. Long live to the comrades who are clear to the cause. I thank you.